Okay, well, good morning, guys and gals. It's a Wednesday midweek, and it's the second round of the float only at Bewdley on the River Severn. Just arrived at the Pines Golf Course. There you are. Bit cloudy, you know. I did come up, but there's a nice bit of sunshine I come through, and then it's gone cloudy. So let's keep our fingers crossed it stays dry. Anyway, that's where the they're having their breakfast, and they do the draw. It's all down to the draw, isn't it? As we all know by now. I get to know it pretty well now, so when I do draw, I got an idea, you know, what to do or where to go. And you know, when I first came here, the first couple of years, didn't have a clue. But yeah, let's see how I do. Last match I came 17th out of what, 54 fishing. I had a good weight, 9 pound odd, 9.8, but just missed out on the section. Anyway, wish you well, and see you at the draw now in a minute.
The gate's shut when the last man's gone through. The old star out of the way now, so next lot of parking is a dowel, so it'll be
far. Right, well, still waiting to do the draw because Jeff likes to rabble on a bit, same old stuff every week. But I'm in the pleasurable task to give Dave Roberts a section win from last Sunday, so let's go and record that. All right, Dave.
All right.
Dave, I got some money for you.
No way.
You got a section win.
Oh, well done, mate. I did see. I didn't realise. I thought you'd won our section, but thank you very much.
Well, no, I was third in the match, so anyway, happy days.
We had a good day, really, for a test section. Cheers.
Cheers, mate.
They do to draw a good and stand on the wall, be taller than Jeff.
Yes.
Nobody's I've left to the end, so see what happens.
The Welsh paparazzi.
Paparazzi, yeah.
What are you after? Come on, I want to see what you
studied for. Hey, I want to see you open yours.
Yeah, so you can turn around and say, fucking match organisers.
You need a different watch and dive as well.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No. Peg 10. Peg 10, I don't know if that's any good. Is it any good?
Proper good draw. Is it? Proper draw.
Oh, there you are. Okay. Let's go and log in.
Like
you won. Dave Allen's peg.
Is that
any good today?
No, 89 he drew. Clive, what do you mean?
I don't know. I never been there.
I'll tell you what I'll do as a goodwill gesture, seeing as you've come too far, and I'll swap with
you. Swap you. I dropped that.
That's fucking shit.
I gotta write my name down now, so I'll do that. Okay, well, there you are. After all that bullabaloo, drawn peg 10, and apparently it's a fair peg. So, I'll tell my luck to change a little bit on Bewdley. right, let's get down there. I just spoke to Dave Roxall. He had it last week. He had 8 pound barbel on a whip. it's a float only match, so we can't fish a few today. So, fingers crossed. Let's see what we can do. All right, I'll see you on the peg. It's right up the top of this, of the match line. Peg 5's above me, then peg 10. So, see you there. Okay, well, I've just got to my peg. It's down the track, in amongst some woods. There's a big platform here, and there's a small platform there. It's a bit disconcerting, though, because it's on top of a weir. And it's only about 15, 20 yards trot, if that. So, it's a float-only match. You know, it's going to be working hard by the look of it. There's a bit of a slack on the inside. I don't know if there's any fish there. And the other disconcerting thing is there's pegs opposite. Sometimes people fish them as well. It's like double banked. Hopefully, fingers crossed, nobody will turn up today. So there we are. There's my peg 10. Famous peg 10. It's It's won a few matches apparently, but let's hope it goes today. If not, I'll try my best. Okay. Okay, just 5 minutes ago now. Again, I'm going to try and keep it simple because I thought of all sorts of things, you know, chubbard, wagglers, and all sorts. But I'm going to stick to a plan. I'm going to fish the pole, holding back with a flat float, only, you know, just off the edge of the bush, and then I got a stick float to trundle down afterwards. So I'm going to see how that goes. Otherwise, it's a bit too coloured, I think, for the wabbler, you know, going out there. I know Jeff Brady had a bag of fish off here on the wabbler, but I think there must have been clear conditions because it's just a bit muddy today, a bit mucky. So that's my plan. We're going to fish the casters and hemp, bait dropping it, yeah. Let's see. It's about 3-4 pints of casters with a pint of hemp in mix that. And I got my maggots as well, red maggots, my favourite. And I got worm as well, so I might, you know, might chop and change with a worm. It's going to be a big fish. Smallest size hook I got on is a 14, so I'm going for it today. If it don't work, it don't work, you know, so I've got to take my chance, you know. Okay, so wish me luck and I'll see you now to start the match. Okay, match actually started. 1 minute past 12, so give it a minute. Right, I'm going to bait drop it first. The pole. Make too much of a disturbance. Put two lots in, I think, just to get him interested. Two pole rig set up, so I keep a bait drop on one and just use this for running through or holding back. Double cast to begin with. So threading one up the line, or on the hook, I should say. And the other one like that. small fish having a little nibble at. Try a single caster, see what happens. It's a 4.5 gram flat float. Right then. Yeah, I think it's small fish there. I don't know whether to go for them or not. Yeah, just shredded my caster then. So, have another go. Single caster. Early days yet. And the big crop in. I might even have go on the meat later, because apparently there's some barbel on this peg. And there's a nice bush further down, so you know. Single caster again. Sure, I'm over depth a little bit, I've just come off the bottom a little bit, or shallow up a little bit. Got a worm, I think. Yeah, that was just shelled in half. They bit that cast in half then. So, it's probably a bigger bait. Never know, it might be a perch on your own. Try a single caster again. A little bleak, small fish topping around. It's looking a bit ominous. Yeah, small fish are just right in the cache in it. Let me put a maggot on, see what happens. Same thing, they're just nibbling the end. I put two casters on it. I know a lot of people fish a whip, but you look something decent, you've added. That's my philosophy. They'll come, I'm sure they will come. If you bump the fish then, probably a small one. To feed the small fish off first. Thank you.
we'll cast up. Billy. I wasn't expecting that. I put double maggot on even though I haven't fed any yet.
tablet. Big drop in. Thank you. Two one zero on. think those fish are going further out, so I'm going to start loose feeding now. So. But how's it been fishing?
It's fished hard until I got up to Steve Williams on peg 18.
Yeah?
He's up 10 pound of silvers and 4 barbel.
Oh, is he really? Oh my God.
It's fished hard all the way up.
Eh?
All the way up from the town it's fished hard.
Hard, is it?
Yeah. You've had no chub show, haven't you?
No, I'd won about that. Couple of perch, little dace. And I went on a flat float and I lost something, bloody come off.
Right.
No, but I've enjoyed it, I might have 10 pounds, I don't know,
You might have 10 pounds.
Yeah.
That's big point.
Huh?
That's good point.
Is it a good point today?
Good point. It is.
Yeah, only small stuff, I'm ashamed, I no chub and nothing,
We've got half an hour.
Yeah.
Then chub can turn up.
You never know. Yeah, so where have you all from, right?
From the town. I've been down to Mr. Maguire because he's lost 2 landing nets.
Oh.
He's got them back, but
all right.
I've been down the bottom of the town.
Yeah.
So
you're going to get plenty of them,
Yeah. Oh, there's a few of them being caught.
Yeah.
But, 72s and up around there, that was owning up to 2-3 pounds, I think.
Yeah. I know Russell phoned up, he said he's only got...
He's got 2, but he just had his second chub when I got there.
Oh, did he? Yeah. All right. You said he was struggling,
So... Where that downstream wind's killing him.
Yeah.
So, but Steve's fishing the centipede and holding it back.
Is he really? Centipede? Well.
And he's just holding it back.
Yeah. Maybe that's what you should do, yeah.
Right, I wish you all the best and I'll see you in half.
All right, yeah, see you in a minute, eh?
Yeah, I'll be perch just coming this way.
Yeah.
All the best, thank
you. All right, mate, see you in a bit. Well, it's been hard by the look of it. Half hour to go now. Scousman just come and said he struggled, and then, except for Steve Williams below, he's got two barbel and about £10 a bit. So, anyway. I have lost one, to be honest, on a pole, big fish, but oh, just yuck, bloody come off. But you know, I was catching quite consistently to begin with, a little roach, little dace and some perch. And gudgeon, had some gudgeon. Yeah, I switched to the maggots and I started catching again. Casters, they went off. Really struggle now. It's all this. I'll go down here to the bottom. small chub. Coughing up the maggots. Okay, I just nearly all over. Let's just wait for the weigh-in now. Okay, the match is over now. A couple of little fish right to death. Didn't get no bonus fish, unfortunately. I had that one on I lost on the pole, but that was it. So anyway. Interesting, because the scalesman just come up and said he's fished hard all the way through, except for when the lads just down there got a couple of barbel and some fish. So you never know. You know, I'm hoping I got double figures anyway. So weigh in, and depends on how I've done, whether I go back or not, because it's a long drive home. Okay, so see you in a bit then, let's see what we got. Okay, they're up 11
11 because there was another fish still in the net. Anyway, what can I say? Well, Ian's beat me up there. He's had 14, and the guy and Philip Lowe's beat me as well. So, but I've enjoyed it. I've had a nice day. I don't know. You never know. I might get a section on default or something. But what I'll do, I won't go back now. I'll try and find out the results and put them on the end because, as I say, it's a 2.5 hour run for me. But I love it. I love this river. It's another view. Reminds you of the Taff, my river back home. Like, you know, shallow, fast. Just unfortunately, the fish died a death on me, and I lost that bonus fish. But never mind. Okay. Thanks for watching, and please put your comments. And hope it was a better angle this week. I know lately I haven't had much room to show, so at least I've had plenty of room to place the camera this week. Anyway, okay. All the best. See you on the next one. Thank you.